Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the daily update. Hope you guys had a good day trading today. Market is up 1.38% on the S&P, but I do believe we did see the NASDAQ finally leading the market here. I think it's been a while since we saw the NASDAQ leading the market. Again, it's you know, the market has been rotating, right? The rotation occur in different sectors. That's what we saw in November, December, and some parts of January. You know, NASDAQ, its big brother, was slowing down so that the small caps and the banks can catch up. Now that small caps and the banks, you can see, you know, small caps is up 8% year to date. The banks is up about 5% year to date. And, you know, banks actually did make new all-time highs. Not new all-time highs, I mean at all-time high level here. It was extremely lagging for longest time. Remember when NASDAQ was well above the all-time high, banks were sitting barely 50% retracement from this move here. Now that, you know, the banks got to the all-time high, small caps are thriving. I think the NASDAQ decided it wants to kind of take over that leadership. So we saw that the NASDAQ up 2.3% while the S&P is up 1.3%. But let's stick with our 65-minute chart here on the S&P. I'll try to dissect this thing as much as I can to figure out what we can expect going into tomorrow. So it looks like this is where it closed. We gapped up pretty significantly today. And good thing about it is it gapped above the resistance. And we talked about the yesterday. You see there's this down gap, right? Yesterday gap up was below this down gap. And then it fell lower. But we talked about how that it favors the buyers, the fact that the partial gap remains open. We found support on that short-term moving average, and the price managed to stay above it throughout the day yesterday. And when we saw that gap up today, it was definitely well above this high here, and it's above this high right here. And then on that first hour, we saw the thrust. We didn't see a fade like we saw yesterday after the gap up. And this gap up was much bigger. Let's actually measure this. I'm just kind of curious here because I wasn't watching this morning. It's 0.6% gap up. Interesting, actually, they're both about the same amount of gap up. I guess sometimes it does do the charts. The visuals can be a little tricky, right? This is actually pretty simple. Well, you know what? Let me actually do it again. Let's do it again. I think let me do a little bit more precisely. So 0.7. Let's call that 0.7. Let's do this one. I think just because the way it moved, it felt like so pretty identical gap up. Pretty identical gap up. So about 0.7, 0.68. percent gap up, 0.65. It's a very identical gap up. I think it just looks like it's a much bigger gap up because I think it was much more smoother. We didn't see like it gapped up above this major resistance, and then it continued to move higher on the first hour, and that was it. I mean, we, you know, first hour move, second hour we held above it, third, fourth, fifth. And then we did see a little bit of pullback on the last hour, but we did see that on the third. So basically, 1 hour move, 1 hour rest. 1 hour move, 1 hour rest. 1 hour move, 1 hour rest. That's what we're seeing here. So what do we have right now? Well, this market is continuing to cultivate higher highs and higher lows. Do you guys know what that means? It does not mean it's gonna go straight up every single day and we're never gonna see a pullback. That's not what it means. When I say cultivation of higher lows and higher highs, benefit of the doubt goes to the buyers, that means even if we do see a pullback like we saw here and like we saw here, it means if we see a pullback from here, it has higher probability of cultivating the next higher low before making higher high. That's what it means, right? When I say we have a cultivation of higher lows and higher highs, benefit of the doubt goes to buyers. That's what it means, right? So benefit of the doubt goes to the buyers today does not mean it has to keep going high. And it could, definitely could keep going higher. But should the price slide going into next days, it has a high probability of finding support at a certain level before making a move and cultivating that higher low and making another higher high, because that's how it has been moving, higher highs and higher lows here. So I think, you know, just looking at this right here, it looks like my short-term moving average is just hovering beneath that 380, protecting this gap area. So if we do see any kind of a sharp decline or something like that, you know, I expect 381 is going to act as support. Or we could also consolidate a little bit before this thing continue to move higher. So at this point, bears have nothing except the fact that there might be some kind of shenanigan. But at this point, we want to continue to give benefit of the doubt to the buyers. However, last time I checked my oscillator, I think buyers are getting tired. The only question is, are the bears going to take advantage of this? Let's actually remove this resistance here because he thrust it above today. So the only question is, how are the bears going to utilize this sentiment here? So we can see that overbought sentiment. We can see that overbought sentiment. We can see that overbought sentiment. And we're at that overbought sentiment. And so you can see, you know, back in like mid-December, we did see a pullback. Late December, we moved sideways for a couple days and even moved, like made another high here before finally pulling back. But we did find support there. Early January, it moved sideways for entire like 2 weeks. You can see that we moved sideways. That's what we call correcting through time, right? And then it gave you a little bit of head fake right here with that gap down. I think that's when a lot of people panicked here, right? So when we saw the price correcting through time, moving sideways while my oscillator comes down, a lot of people are very anxious about where this market is going to break out. Is it upside or downside? And then when we saw the gap down here, I think it trapped both directions. A lot of shorts thought that this gap down is going to be the gap down. It's going to take this to back down to 360 or lower. A lot of bulls got really scared when we saw the gap down, because it was that support right here. You see that support right here, right on that 377. Once we lost that slightly, right, the bulls closed out their longs thinking it looks bearish, but then that was a low before going higher. And you can check my video back in 15th, and you know, we talked about how you don't want to come to a dramatic conclusion, because we've seen these type of moves before. How many times are you gonna let this market scare you out and you end up missing out big rallies like these, right? So just because we're getting overbought doesn't always mean we're gonna have corrections right away or pullback right away. We're talking about short term because we're looking at 65 minute chart. We could see correcting through time like these, you know, sort of these events that we saw in the past, or we could see kind of dripping lower action here like we saw in mid-December. We wouldn't know at this point. But here's another scenario that I can show you if we go back further out. But this thing could actually move sideways a little bit, you know, and then like this a little bit, and then this thing kind of flattens out a little bit, right? And then make a higher high, this thing going back up to the top of its band. That's another scenario that we're not seeing on the example that I've shown you here, here, and here. So give benefit of the doubt to the buyers We'll come back tomorrow. We'll re-examine. We'll go from there. Enjoy your evening and good luck trading tomorrow.